Is it okay to use CBD oil for muscle inflammation pain?
Yes, it is absolutely fine. CBD oil originating from hemp is preferred. So it does not have THC, which is the substance that, you know, people can get high if they take that in through a number of means, either smoking it or, you know, in baked goods, etc. So CBD oil is fine. And what El Morya is saying is that you should bless it before you ingest it. You can put it on your skin and rub your skin with love and affection toward your body. You can call to your body elemental to help with whatever issues you are having, and give your body elemental the full authority to utilize the intelligence within the substance of the CBD oil from hemp to bring balance and harmony back to your muscles, your joints, ligaments, tendons, etc. Remember that there is an intelligence within the cells, within every plant in nature that God embedded there. And when we communicate with the oil itself and through the oil, the plant that bore that oil, and we actually make a mindful connection to what the purpose of that plant is, because every plant has a purpose, then we can, through this communication and through love and understanding and the connection that we have through that communication, unlock the virtues within that plant that then are concentrated in that oil. So blessing the oil will always amplify its effectiveness for our healing. Blessing our food will do the same. Of course, we know this. Charging it with conscious love and light. And it creates kind of a almost like an even divine placebo effect, where even if the plant was compromised in some way, or maybe it was not extracted in the highest way, let's say they used heat instead of a cold press process, we can add back the illumining and the healing positive effects of the original blueprint of that plant by making that connection and blessing it and asking for it to have its highest aspects for our healing and nurturing. Practitioners who use sacred oils and holy essences, who are conscious, always bless what they use before they apply it in massage treatments or in other ways. And the blessing of it will amplify the healing virtues of the plant or the oil or whatever, the scent, and it will unlock its cosmic effects, its virtues. Because, you know, we have our virtues, right? Well, every plant has virtues. And what are those virtues? Well, often the virtues of the plant are within the essence of the plant, which it can be extracted through a number of means, often through the oil or through the essence. So when we make that sacred connection with life in any way, and we bless whatever it is, we enter into the oneness through that blessing that is itself the healing aspect of light. When we bless something virtuously and lovingly, it unlocks its highest aspects and virtues, and then it can work to our benefit and the benefit of others. So remember always to bless your food, what you take in, what you drink, etc. And remember, you can always put, like if you have a container that that oil is in, just as we have, Dr. Emoto taught us, we can write a quality or a virtue or something positive on the bottles, you can do the same with your CBD oil. So if you got it from a source at a store or online, write, you know, healing or wholeness or elasticity or health or well-being or something on that little bottle, and then consciously, just for a few seconds, make contact with it, and through your divine intelligence and its divine intelligence, it will work to your benefit. Remember Anastasia's teaching about putting seeds in our mouths with our own saliva. Well, El Morya says if you do ingest the CBD oil, allow it to rest in your mouth just for a few moments and make contact with your saliva. And the saliva has enzymes in it, right, which help in food digestion. So the saliva will help to immediately allow the transferring of the virtues or the healing aspects of that, what is in the CBD oil, to then go into your body through your bloodstream as the oil goes down through your esophagus and then into the stomach and then eventually the intestines and then to the blood. So the more you know of the science of the body and the body elemental, and you lovingly communicate, this is like the divine placebo effect. It has almost as much of a benefit for healing as the substance itself when you bless it. So you could almost take something that you believe to be something, if you believe it is that substance, and then you bless it, it starts actually manifesting the qualities as if it were that substance. That's why the placebo effect is so powerful, because the faith of the person has made that little white pill that doesn't have anything but just a little sugar in it actually be powerful because of the belief of the person, right? So we know this, and yet do we utilize that understanding? Not very often, maybe. So anything that you take in with love, with joy, enjoying it, and laughing and chewing it or eating, you know, consuming it with conscious awareness, it will work for you and yield great benefits, the master says. It's more about our consciousness, how we eat, all that. And, you know I have a lot to work on to put all this into practice, and many of us do. If we live a hurried life, sometimes we just, you know, we're kind of off, you know, we eat quickly and we're off doing something. Well, slow down, enjoy your meal, enjoy even taking in your supplements, you know, bless them, see them, adding their impetus to your body temple and recreating you. And, you know, our cells regenerate, what, every 7 years? Every cell in our body, pretty much. I don't know about the nerve cells. They say that those can't be regenerated, but I believe anything can be. Yet, if most of our cells are regenerated every 7 years, think of how you can communicate with your cells, and then when they regenerate, they're more youthful again, and you become younger and more youthful. So how is that done? Through consciousness, through the application of the truths that we know of this master's teachings in a very practical way in our daily lives, and through the little things that we do, through the little rituals that we observe, and how we actually spend our time in this kind of super conscious state. So thank you for that question, Soledad, and God bless you.